Hello, my name is Walter, and welcome back to The Get Down, Season 1, Episode 10. This is called, Gamble Everything, which is most probably because they gambled everything in the last episode, so, we're gonna see the consequences of that, in this episode, and, you know, I think that, a lot of people are, wondering, like, what's my thoughts on this whole series as a whole, and I think that it's very interesting to bring in the musical, and it's always, you know, the passion thing, and you know, it's also the rhetoric that people just don't understand your art form, or people don't understand what you're doing in this life. And my rhetoric is always like, do what you want to do and do what you love. So anyway, I still love this series, so there's one more episode after this, and let's go. Last time on The Get Down, they were forced to bring in the cops, the fuzz, and now everything they built is crumbling down. Or AFAP,
you're either real or you're nothing. Who the hell's your advisor? I'm
Everything. Nice. He's nervous. Yeah, dude, never hang up on a girl. All right, it's pretty good, it's pretty good. Hey, Star Wars.
Thank you.
tonight. On the rise. There it is. Up to the roof, go on, good sir. I'm sensing the mother of Yolanda, man. Drifting under your feet. Oh, metaphors. Pride. Dude, you're not seeing, dude. Yeah. Cheers to that, eh? Such Australian. Rubicon. Mr. Rubicon. Welcome to the Slam Dunkin. Oh, shit's getting real. Hey. Oh, oh. Rubicon. Man, fuck the guy. Fuck the husband, man. Call in Papa Fuerte. That's just weird. What's the name of this mission? And who's gonna get on down? Hey! Oh, she is pretty. She is pretty fine. No go, bruh. Life is hard. All just falling down. Talk to her, bruh. You're the only one left. Is this really the time? Alright, let's just sit down and talk, and hopefully the dad doesn't know how to get to the place. Yeah, she can. And by the way, it's raining, so that's why you can hear like drops. You walk away, sun goes down. By the way, I was singing Amy Winehouse song if you didn't know. Hashtag random. Nice. Good way to start. The box is a little over though, but you know. Show business is all about that razzle dazzle. Hey. Nice. Hashtag risque, son. Nice. Oh, just keep singing. Keep singing. Keep rolling. I believe in you, Marlene. Kiss her before she goes, bruh. Nice. I mean, this is not as risky as I thought it was gonna be, you know? Okay, I get the innuendos, everything, but this is pretty basic. This is like level 3, maybe, hard, like soft hard. When they say like it's really risky until like somebody got sick, I was thinking more of like more innuendos, more metaphors, more reflections. People fucking like jackrabbits, you know, something like that. This is like 1970 risque, I guess. And for a Christian, good, wholesome Christian girl, and you know, daughter of a pastor to do this, you know, it's pretty alright. I mean, it's pretty risque. Guys. Ooh, love, trust. Ah, nice. Oh, this really reminds me of La La Land right now. I guess they kind of borrowed the visual. Just look at that. It's the same purple tint. It's the same lights in the background and the same stars. Come on, just kiss her, bruh. Life change. Really, bruh? Hashtag good night kiss. Son! Snorlax. I saw that. That's true, that's true. Nice. That is weird, bro, but okay. They kissed, right? Yeah, I remember that. Thank you. Show's over. Go. Spread. What are you doing? You're her agent. Ain't nobody should be standing around looking at what just happened. Lightning and thunder. What is that? No. It's gonna be full circle around, isn't it? Coming. Call the police, man. What's happening? Didn't have a choice, bro. Do what? Es violoso. That's sensible. That's a sensible plan, you know. But one thing you're not getting here is that Fat Annie probably has a mom. Just saying. She's high AF, fun. Thank you. What the fuck are you talking about, fam? Dude, you're a drunk ass, man. Son, look at yourself. Bro? Dude, this guy... Yeah, it is. What happened, man? Did he shoot himself or? Well, I mean, he did deserve it. He did deserve it, by the way, because he was getting a big pride ego shit going on. Thanks, Ed. Ed Panky. That was really good. Yeah, he, in my honest opinion, he really deserved that. Like, he deserved to die. Like, I mean, not in a bad way, you know. I'm just saying, like, he deserved what was coming to him. And, you know, he killed himself. But I'm just saying, like, he was straying away from God, you know. If he was really a God's man, you know, he would have had compromise, you know. He would have said, okay, this is what you want to do. All I can say is, may God guide you, or, you know, something along those lines. Like, don't be such a douche. Like, the mom was right as well. Like, she was like, dude, you're just riding the high of my daughter's success, which is like my niece's success, therefore she is successful. So like, what the fuck, right? Anyway, I'm really pissed at that, by the way. Like, so-called people of the faith, like, claiming to have faith, but then, like, drinks and does stupid stuff, like, beat their own wives. Like, that's fucking dumb, okay? Like, I'm sorry. Like, that's not what God teaches you. God teaches you love. God teaches you caring. God teaches you not to hit a person, even though some books were, like, stone people to death and all that, but I don't think God would condone that. Like, seriously, like, that's not something proper, like, to me. Anyway, that was about it, guys, and I will see you in the final episode of this season. See you then.